Welcome to the Roombook Extension for Autodesk Revit 2013. What is a Roombook? Imagine you are planning your house and need to know how much plaster and wallpaper and parquet you need for the interior finish of your rooms. In the context of quantification of Revit projects, Roombook detects the visible surfaces of a room and calculates the materials for the interior finish exactly or based on national standards. Roombook calculates the surface materials of walls and side elements like columns and beams, including niches and reveals, the surface materials of floors and ceilings, the room circumferences, and also furniture elements. The quantification is based on automatic detection and correct calculation under consideration of joints, interaction, calculation rules, plus subtractive and additive subareas. Roombook considers national calculation standards. There's the international standard, which calculates the real quantities, and the German VOB standard, which is a specific opening measurement system according to German construction contract procedures, that is, calculation rules for subtracting openings in walls, floors and ceilings, depending on their size. Project standards can be changed and modified at any time. But not only the calculation standard can be changed, also the language of the Roombook can be changed at runtime. This makes it really easy to work globally in distributed locations. From English you can change to German or to Russian or to Portuguese, Brazil, just as you like it. And the language change does of course not only apply to the user interface, but also to the export. I'm going to show you now how easy it is to do a quantification of surface materials with Roombook. To start the Roombook calculation, you need a floor plan with rooms and walls. Floors, ceilings and furniture elements are only calculated when they exist. The Roombook commands can be found here in the Add-ins tab of Revit. After having set the calculation settings, means the German VOB standard or the international calculation standard, we can directly go on and calculate the room quantities. You can have different types of room quantity calculations within one project while the settings apply to the selection of rooms and the range of calculation. For information is shown here the current calculation standard, here the international, and with the selection button you can select which rooms to include in the calculation. All rooms of the project are listed here and you can very easily specify which rooms to calculate. By the way, the room groups here, room groups are a feature of the area book extension, which is a separate module. Then you specify the range of calculation. For this example, we've selected two rooms now and want to calculate the finish materials which are applied to the surfaces of walls and side elements like columns and beams, materials for floor surfaces, ceiling surfaces. The room circumferences can be used for calculating skirtings or baseboards or even cable length, and the furniture elements. For furniture elements, you can also specify the component category, like furniture, desks or chairs, or specialty equipment like smoke detectors and sockets. If such a component is attached to a room, it will be included in the calculation. And the Excel export even includes nice images so that you have a visual evidence of how the elements look like. Please note that it is also possible to include furniture from linked projects. Okay. So the settings are done and we can now click the calculate button to start the calculation process. Roombook is now detecting and calculating all the surfaces of the rooms which we specified before. When finished, the View Edit Results button becomes enabled and we can watch the results. We've specified two rooms for calculation and for each room are listed the room quantities which are calculated. Here the wall surfaces. All elements which are listed here belong to the wall surfaces of this room. I'm going to show you the surfaces. They are highlighted. You see here all the surfaces which belong to the room office are taken into consideration, and also the surfaces of the columns, because they too can be covered with material. Please remember that Roombook only calculates the visible surfaces. This means if there are columns or beams that are partly integrated in the wall, only the visible surfaces will be calculated because only those can be covered with material. Watch this wall here. It has doors and windows integrated. How does Roombook calculate this wall? Click the expand button to see how this wall is calculated. It consists of one face which is covered with plaster and wallpaper. See here the area. There are walls which are having different faces. This means each face is calculated separately. Or the column, for example, it is a rectangular column, and therefore there are four faces which all are covered with material and each face is listed separately. But now back to this face here. Roombook reports a material requirement of 9.73 square meters for this wall. How come? Click the Sub-Areas tab to see the calculation. From the main surface, Roombook automatically subtracts the integrated door and window openings, and thus is adjusting the material requirement accordingly. Roombook detects and calculates all faces and sub-areas automatically. This is indicated by the detection type Automatic. But of course, there is still room for manipulation by setting the Ignore checkmark, which excludes a subarea from being calculated, or by adding a virtual subarea that has no constructional correspondence in the project. I'm going to define now a virtual tiles panel. I specify the calculation sign plus because it is an additive subarea and a value of, let's say, 5 square meters. The material is taken by default from the main element, but in this case we want to change it. I add the ceramic tiles and remove the plaster and the wallpaper. And here it is. We've defined a virtual subarea which is shown by the detection type numerical. The materials, by the way, are those from the Revit project. Please remember, we are using now the international calculation standard, which calculates the real quantities. When we are using the German VOB standard and its specific opening measurement system, this dialog looks like this. Watch this additional column VOB calculation and the yes-no indicators. VOB specifies that openings in walls up to a size of 2.5 square meters shall not be calculated. What does it mean? This door here is smaller than 2.5 square meters, which means no, it is not calculated according to VOB. The same for this window. It is smaller, therefore it is not calculated. This window here, however, is larger than the VOB limit, therefore yes, it is calculated. But of course, you can still change those settings manually. And if you want to globally change the VOB settings, you just have to change the calculation settings. This means for you, Roombook handles all the tedious calculation and non-calculation of sub-areas automatically. Imagine you'd have to do this by hand in a large building complex. Roombook makes VOB calculation a breeze. Let's go back to the international standard and watch the floor surfaces. The floor of room office is covered with parquet, and when you click on the sub-areas, you see how it is calculated. From the main surface are subtracted two columns. I show you the columns. Here they are, and you see their footing area is automatically subtracted from the main area and thus is calculating correctly the material requirement for this room. Let's go on with the ceiling surfaces. The ceiling surfaces are covered with plaster and wallpaper, and looking at the sub-areas tab, you see there is again a column and a shaft opening which are reducing the material requirement for the ceiling. You can verify it in the project. You highlight the elements and see that this column is touching the ceiling and this shaft opening is required for the stair hole. Therefore, the material requirement of the ceiling is affected by those elements. Like for all automatically detected room quantities, you still have the option to manually add elements or faces to manipulate the calculation. Okay, let's look at the room circumferences here. The main room circumference here is used for calculating the material requirement for skirtings, and in this example I've manually added two elements which are used for calculating cables. Okay, let's quickly move on to furniture elements. All components which are attached to the room are listed here and are included in the Roombook calculation of furniture elements. What you see here, by the way, are the so-called quantity IDs. Roombook labels each calculated element with a unique identifier that, once created, is never changed again. This makes it easy for you to identify later the calculated results in the project and the export. Look here, these are the quantity IDs. After you've finished viewing and editing the results, you can directly go on to the export. There are several possibilities. I select now the export to Excel in a predefined template and simply click the export button. Excel is opened in the background and dynamically filled with data. For each calculated Roombook category is created an own sheet, and at the end there is a survey of all room quantities. The survey of all room quantities lists the total material requirement of all calculated room quantities on a per room basis and in total. Please watch that in addition to the materials for wall surfaces, Roombook also calculates the window area per room. This means the area through which light can fall into the room. This is important information for some countries. But of course you don't have to trust blindly the calculated results. Just go to the tab Wall Surfaces and verify the calculations. For each room are listed all elements and surfaces, the sub-areas, the count, the quantity ID, the surface material, whether it is subtractive or additive, and of course the dimensions. This makes it really easy for you to track back the calculation approach. And the same applies, of course, also to the detailed calculation lists for floor surfaces, ceiling surfaces, and room circumferences. For furniture elements is additionally included an illustration of the calculated objects. Cool! And if you don't have Excel installed, you can also export the results to CSV to read in other spreadsheet programs. And the same information as in the Excel file, except for the nice illustrations of course, can also be exported to predefined schedule tables that can be loaded in the project. And here you are, you have all the Roombook calculations also available in the Revit project as native Revit schedules. Last not least, you can export the Roombook data to a Revit DWIF file, load it in Autodesk Quantity Takeoff, and have all the Roombook calculation available in this DWIF file for further use in QDO. Okay, this was a short overview about the Roombook extension and how easy it is to calculate surface materials based on rooms. I've not covered everything, there's a lot more. Please go and give it a try. But there's one last thing which I would like to mention. One of the new features of Roombook 2013 is the calculation of building part quantities. This is a response to customer requests, and as a first step we've integrated the calculation of windows, doors and openings. The principle is very similar to the Roombook. You select the objects, you click the calculate button, the project is scanned for the objects, and when finished you can view and edit the results. Here are all the windows that were found in the project. These are the doors, different kinds of openings. Okay, and then you click the export button. Excel is opened and dynamically filled with data, while for each window and door is created an illustration so that you have a visual control of how the objects look like. And of course you can not only export to Excel but also to CSV, DWIF and schedules. Thank you for your attention, and please find the Roombook extension for Revit 2013 live in Subscription Center.